Right, it's time for the paper review now. Let's get to see what the headlines are across the papers in Nigeria today.
Yes, indeed.
All right.
And of course, we've been joined by journalist and social commentator, regular on the show, Charles Idaho. It's good to see you.
Good morning. Glad
good
to
morning,
be here.
Okay. Charles. Nice Thank to you see you. Yes,
you're looking like Malam Bature.
Well, last time you told me it was Ohani
Ferry.
Ohani Ferry.
We tried to.
All right. Let's begin with the Punch newspaper this morning. VP Oshibaja restates support for state police. There's a quote here that says, "Today, the challenges that we are facing are enormous. A federation of 200 million people and a state cannot control its own police. There must be state police." That's quoting the vice president.
Yeah, some would say you're preaching to the choir.
Yeah.
But he has repeatedly said, he has never hidden his
sentiment
concerning that in favor of state police, which of course I agree with him, because if you have close to 200 million people in a country, policed by just less than 500,000, half a million of a police force that is policing close to 200 million, well, it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, but the point there is, Nigerians are saying, you are saying the exact thing in our minds. Who has the powers to start the process?
Well, the very first problem.
If a member of the authority is making the same kind of statement Nigerians are making, then what's the point?
It will gain traction if, for instance, he is on the same page as the president.
Earlier
in the year, you heard when the president said he doesn't believe in state police. There's something wrong with the existing
structure of
plateau. If you have that, you'll have a discordant tune from the same institution. There's a problem. But assuming the president will flow with him, then that could now generate the necessary drive for us to now say, okay, let's also go to the parliament and see how we can convince them. That is conviction, to see how they can start to now tinker with the necessary, the relevant sessions of the constitution for us to be able to say, okay, let's see how we can go.
People say,
oh, we're not right. But the question is, when are we going to, if you don't try it, how do we progress?
All right. Well, we wait to see how that plays out. Teleology finally takes over Nine Mobile, appoints directors. So after changing from Metisala to Nine Mobile, in just a few months, or just about a year thereabout, we are now going to have Teleology.
There's an antecedent in this cousin.
Yeah,
we started with Econet to V Mobile to this, and then I don't mind changing of names or nomenclature, but as far as they are changing name, let the service be
improved. Yeah.
So that's why I don't mind. I mean, it's just what's in the name, really.
Okay.
You know,
a rose by any other name. It's like a rose.
Governors against local government autonomy are Nigeria's enemies.
Yes.
Obasanjo is saying that, you know, the concept of the idea of autonomy is still on the front burner.
Well, he should know, because he was supervising the affairs of Nigeria in 1976 when the local government reform was better.
Mm.
And then he knew the reason why it was for the three tiers of government to be independent of each other.
Yes.
So that you can local government can derive their funding directly from the center.
Mm-hmm.
But what you have now is they've been pocketed. And that's why you find a lot of things. If you are not in the good book of the governor, you won't be a chairman. It's not supposed to be so. Can you imagine if the federal government will now be pocketing state government? It's not possible.
All right.
So why should be allowed?
Let's just run through some of the headlines here and then we move on. Court revokes Oji Kalu's bail over Germany trip. And federal government borrowed over 2 trillion naira to fund 2017 budget. The DMO is saying that. And then Buhari says stolen funds stashed away abroad, signs extradition bill. All right. Federal government foreign agencies to sign $900 million power transmission deals, and police arraign Togolese cook for Credit Suisse chairman's murder. Federal government's 1,300 seas of oil repairs roads in 14 universities.
All right, to the nation now. Buhari or Shibajo lash out at restructuring advocates. Zabakoba Okorie, Babatope disagree. Well, President Buhari is speaking in Paris, has been saying all the people talking about restructuring, they've just been talking about it so lazily that, look, they need to come out and tell us exactly what kind of restructuring they mean. Should we go back to the three regions that we used to have? now that we have 36 states? You know, so many questions.
Yeah, that's my problem with this restructuring. In as much as I also want to travel that same route with the proponents, but the question is that on what basis? I keep saying it here that we need to look at the template upon which it will operate. You just mouth it. Oh, we need restructure. Everybody wants to curry favor from us either by surrendering our mandate. All they need to do is just wave the flag of
yeah. But don't you think? I mean, look, the whole idea of restructuring. Yeah, everybody agrees that in principle we really should restructure the federation.
On what
and
basis,
then maybe we now come together another confab or something.
No. We don't need them
to talk about. What kind of restructuring?
What I'm saying. Look, I don't know why people still talk about the confusion. The concept of regions that we've been talking about. We've long gone past that right now. Mm-hmm. We cannot go back to the regions as they were at that time anymore. We now have states. We just talked about state police now. It's part of the restructuring.
But we can't do without... Okay, we may not call them regions.
It's not backdoor.
We cannot call them...
so many elements of restructuring.
We have a very effective geopolitical system right now, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. which we can use effectively. For instance, the six south-south states, mm-hmm. they form what is known as the Braid State Commission.
Yes.
I mean, deriving the bills from as an acronym for the six states, mm-hmm. Bayelsa, Rivers, and so on.
Yes.
Which, of course, started, and they really wanted economic integration of the six states that are culturally affined, linguistically affined, and so on. Then you also have the Dawn Commission here in the
Southwest.
If we could use all these platforms, I'm sure it could work.
But what is stopping the states from doing what they want to do?
But I can tell you what happened in the issue of the British Commission. Mm. Insincerity. I mean, Delta, how much are you going to be bringing? Do how much are you going to be bringing?
At the end of the day,
centrifugal forces now pull them away from the center.
So the real question is sincerity of purpose.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
that seems
right.
to be missing.
Exactly. Because in true terms, we all are not confused that when we talk about restructuring.
Even with these things, you
we
see
know, we know what we're talking about. But the concept of the existence of Nigeria or the unity of Nigeria, that's not the negotiable.
The question is, who is willing to bail the cat?
Let's tinker with the system. How about tinkering with the system?
Okay.
Don't let's call it restructuring.
Tinker with
the system.
However, as far as Nigeria remains one and united.
Exactly.
Simple as ABC. Okay, NDIC failed Skybank directors for probe. Oil to stay within $80 per barrel. How will that benefit Nigeria remains to be seen. EFCC recovers 794 billion naira, 407 houses. Of course, EFCC has been saying it has been able to successfully prosecute a number of people in the last 3 years. But 100 and how many cases?
Well, you can say A plus, but how many have been jailed? You fight corruption is not just prosecuting them and then they go, you give them a pact at the back and say, go see no more. What is happening in the Philippines, Rodrigo Duterte, I may not buy his modus operandi about killing, but I think we have a lot to borrow from him and bring it here. Catch people, prosecute them and send it to jail or whoever is culpable. Mm-hmm. But when you just give a pat on the back, or go see no more, let's see Miemwe gold that you stole.
Well, since Nigeria needs all the funds it can get, maybe the Miemwe gold will actually work.
If you stay too long with Miemwe gold,
you're going to have to translate what you
Okay.
Court remands Togolese cook for alleged murder of Ondo chief. Of course, Teleology Nigeria Limited takes over Nine Mobile. Raw unfolds Eagles training regime.
All right. Daily Sun is our next one now. We're just going to run through now because of time. As President rounds off Paris Peace Summit, Buhari is saying that stolen funds must be returned. Okay. He's always very vehement.
So who does the returning?
No, of course, there are processes.
Sweden. Was it Sweden? One of these Scandinavian countries was saying that they were giving us conditionalities. What will we do to return the money? Mm. So I don't know who's going to
return.
And he's
been asking the global community to actually support. To do
if the global community doesn't provide a safe landing for these people, how would they be able to? So they are also culpable.
Yeah, he actually spoke to that. They're culpable in Paris too.
All right, it's sad Desiani not facing trial in the UK. EFCC is saying this, and they said we have 703 convictions, says Magu. Mm-hmm. And a search of Atiku's plane premeditated. The
campaign organization is saying that. Kalu's lawyer explains absence and court revokes as court revokes bail, says ex-governor recuperating in Germany. The lawyer was saying that he had surgery in Germany.
But the search of articles, can we a little broach it?
Vanguard has it in bold caption here. Plain search, Buhari Atiku at each other's throats. Buhari ordered the search, says Atiku. You're whipping up sentiments, according to Buhari.
No, I don't want to. Whoever is better among them, we want whoever can repair Nigeria. I don't see anything wrong in searching. I've been asking questions. I've made calls to evil evasion experts.
Mm-hmm.
It's a standard process. So I think there's no need for us to start whipping up this sentiment. Because if, for instance, unless you are flying by maybe presidential, one of the planes, on the presidential fleet. That's the only one that is exempted from because that's what the presidential wing. Any other one, the other private, or, so I
well,
don't think
again, the question
anything.
Is it the first time he's traveling and coming
is it the first
back
time he'll be searched?
And he'll be searched?
Amici have been searched, governors have been searched. So I don't think, I think we should just leave those
there. Buhari to diaspora Nigerians, you won't vote in 2019. I'm sure they won't be happy.
I don't think they have been captured. I don't think they've been captured.
They've not been captured.
So how can they vote if they've been captured? So we still have a long way to go.
There is no question to that. We all know diasporans cannot vote.
They can't vote. There's no need to flog
that. Has been saying it's going to take a lot of process and it will cost some, you know, to be able to do that. I'm for state police, stronger state, says Oshimbajo Vice President. Fuel subsidy must go, Ezekwesili. Of course, she's been listing out the seven, what she'll do to
how to fix Nigeria.
Plaguing Nigeria.
They look tempting. They sound tempting.
Very tempting.
Yeah, tempting,
huh?
But...
And who says she's
not, the votes for
she
her?
Doesn't have what it takes?
But where are the votes for her?
Maybe Nigerians are not hearing enough
to surrender that mandate to her. I don't know. I wouldn't even vote for women presidents. I don't know.
Okay, I guess that's it. INEC PDP allays fears over omission of Tambuwal's name. Alleged $12 million fraud. Why we released Uzodinma, the allegations that he was given some 26 billion naira contract under the last administration to dredge the
Calabar. No, Chia and Lolo are there today.
There will be time for that today.
No time.
The Daily Trust is our last paper now. Yeah. How civil servants return to posts after losing primaries. There was a revelation there. Teleology finally acquires Nine Mobile. Okay, that's no longer news. We've taken that before. Buhari signs bill on extradition for others. APC Imo Guba candidate, Senator Uzodinma arrested. Okay, still the controversy is on.
But I think the case is on. I was calling him candidate. I thought the thing is be kept in abeyance for now. I don't know whether
INEC had forwarded his APC had forwarded his name. His name to INEC. Okay. So he's
so who, let there. A better person come. Yeah.
41 parties field candidates for Lagos governorship. That's
41?
Interesting. Really? 41? Are they up to 41?
41?
There are 91 parties for crying out loud, so
I cannot know why the other parties are not winning. The balkanization, of the system.
All parties are equal in the eyes.
No, they're equal. But again, if you say a must have before you, what do? You rally the support of others, and then you become
the bigger
one. They are all going their separate ways.
Well, it's an experiment. That is politics. How Sky Bank was run down by directors. NDIC is revealing this. Well, this is coming now. Okay, from this headline, Sky Bank was run down. At that time, they told Nigerians, no problem, nothing
no
happened.
No cause for alarm.
No cause for alarm.
And then
no
you now went to Polaris and then...
Leave
that to money people.
Yeah, exactly. The money people will know how to... Charles Idaho, thank you so much for coming on the program.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay. Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right, still to come on TVC Breakfast. Who exactly is the Speaker of the Ondo State House of Assembly? Why are some of the lawmakers fleeing the state?
And how will the umpires be resolved? These are some of the issues. And former Petroleum Minister Desiani Alice Madueke may be in Nigeria soon to answer to charges of alleged corruption as the EFCC begins the process of extraditing her from the UK.
And how will this pan out? That's a question this morning. And when two elephants fight, the grass suffers. Learning activities have been grounded in tertiary institutions nationwide, and students have been sitting at home. Will the federal government negotiate with ASU to end the strike?
All right, and Boko Haram has been technically defeated, but still ravaging and causing havoc in part of the north.
When will residents of Nigeria's northeast go to bed feeling safe? That's a big question. Stay tuned for more of this discussion.